Oh yeah, by the way. Hi. And now we're actually in I know my city. So yeah, this is where we are now. On the bus, going to Regent's Park instead of being on underground because it's quite hot. And it's not really dingy, but you know, the bus is usually better for me. So it's cleaner, and you get more sun, you get more scenery. Yeah. So it's a bit slower, I suppose, because of traffic and everything else.
Should I have done it this way? Where you can actually see that I'm on the bus. Yeah, so as you can see, on the bus, not that many people there. I think there's about 5 people at the front, and then I'm at the back. Also, why I love the bus is that there's double-decker buses, so you can sit at the top, get a good view of what's happening, and yeah, the top is always, for me, like, much airier, and I suppose it's where kids like to be. Maybe I'm a big kid. So this is my case for my Oyster card. Obviously, I'm a Batman fan. But yeah, this has always been my Oyster card case. So this is what the Oyster card looks like. I think it costs about £5 for an Oyster card. Buy it, load it, and that was the only way that you could pretty much use public transport in London. And then I think over the last couple of years they've changed it so that you can use Google Pay. And I think probably, well, I don't know why I keep saying Google Pay, I guess because that's what I use. But you can pretty much use Google Pay or Google Pay, any other kind of payment method. Why I still use an Oyster is that I feel like I can top up and keep better track of my spending on public transport. So I know if I put £20, then you know that's what's in there and I can't really go over it unless I need to. But also what's great about this is that it has an emergency fare that kicks in. So let's say I've only got £1 and I tap, it'll give me like what's called, it'll just say emergency fare, and so it will give me a minus balance, but it means that I can at least go on like the bus. I think the emergency fare is actually for the bus only. So it means that I can actually go on the bus and get to where my next stop, whatever, and then top up. It was meant to be for night outs especially, so that people aren't left behind on a night out or when you're drunk or something like that and you can't really get home because you only have like 80p or something in your card. So the idea is that it's supposed to get you to your next stop where you hopefully can top up and get help if you need help. And that's pretty much what it was designed for in terms of the emergency fare. So I think it's great. So it's great because also like sometimes you do forget to top up your card. Sometimes you do forget, you know what I mean? Like you run your own and stuff. And so when that emergency fare kicks in, just it's a bit of a like, top up your card. And yeah, awesome. Also, one of the reasons why I love traveling on the bus is because these days they have buses that have like a USB charging port, so at least then it means that I can charge my phone while I'm on the bus.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
Fine, and you?
I'm good, thank you. Can I get one scoop in a cup of the banana caramel, please? Thank you.
Banana caramel?
Yes.
Take a cup.
Yes, please. But yeah, check it out. It is big. Okay, so here we are. This is Regent's Park. I have come through Clarence Gate. That's usually the gate that I come through because I would have come past Baskin Robbins. Some ice cream. And yeah, so that's my usual entrance. And then I kind of come through here And I go across the bridge. There's a bridge, this bridge on the other side, and that's where I usually kind of chill. And the bandstand actually is behind this tree. So I'm going to take you around. This is kind of like, it's a cool area already on the other side, I think. There's benches, and then there's obviously people on the water. I've never been on one of those. I suppose I haven't been here with someone else. Have I been here? I've actually been here with a friend before, actually. But we didn't do any of that stuff. I feel like it's a lot of work, so I don't know. So yeah, I mean, this is the park. It's really stunning. It's huge. So there's different parts to it, because it's this part, and then there's the other part on the other side where it's the Rose Garden. There's other kind of mini gardens as well, and also there's the open air theater, which I usually come to in the summer. It's lovely. They always do like different productions and stuff, and it's always fun. Usually kid friendly, but it's nice because it's like open air, and then you can like take a picnic blanket, you can actually bring in like your own food, or you can order food from there, and they do like these kind of like almost like picnic options and stuff. So I've had a good time there. I think I watched Little Shop of Horrors there, which I actually did in high school. So I was one of like the three urchins in high school. So it was nice to kind of see it, the reproduction of it, I suppose, live, because obviously there is a musical that's there, with Tichina, Arnold, that musical, which is dope. So we did that in high school, and then yeah, coming to see Little Shop of Horrors here was quite cool, which is kind of fun. So yeah, there is lots to do here. It's pretty awesome. One of the things that was said is that when it first opened, it was referred to as a pleasure garden, and couldn't agree more. So that's the bandstand behind me. Usually like on a Sunday and stuff, they'll get like a band that'll come and sit up there and yeah, play. So it's usually more like I guess classical bands, like quartet or strings, brass, you know, that kind of stuff. It's usually quite nice actually, and then people kind of sit in those chairs or along like I guess the river, the pond, the water basically, and you know, yeah, you just come and chill and you listen to the band playing in the background and you have like a little picnic, and yeah, a really good atmosphere. Although with the chairs actually you have to pay, I think you have to pay like either for the day or per hour or whatever. They give you a receipt and yeah, that's it. But for the most part, people like tend to bring their own, either bring your own like camping chair or bring like your own picnic blanket and stuff and do that instead, because then it's like cheaper and yeah, also better, I suppose. So it's like more, if you use a chair, it's more like if you couldn't be bothered really to bring your own stuff, so at least you know that they're there. So the chairs actually, they are spread across the park, so you'll find that there'll be these chairs in different places, so it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to take one from here. So you just go to a place, find a chair, take a seat, and there'll always be someone patrolling to see if you got a receipt for the chair, and if not, then they'll just ask you to get off. So it might be that you might just come in, sit on the chair, and then yeah, when it comes to paying up, get up. But you know, you can pay for the hour, don't be all cheapo. Think about like an hour, pound for an hour or something like that. Well, pound for like 3 hours actually. It's not that expensive for the chairs. But you know, sometimes it's like a pound goes a long way, so you opt out of it. So on the other side of the bank, there, it looks like that's where you get the paddle boats. That's what they're called. What are they saying? Like bicycles on water or something like that. But yeah, paddle boats. Never been on one. Would need to try it at a time when I'm feeling a bit more, you know, athletic. Because yeah, usually I just come here to relax and yeah, take some quality time, some steam off and stuff, and yeah, paddling isn't necessarily the thing that I want to do, but at the same time I suppose you can paddle at your own pace and spend time on the water. Okay, so this is how big the place is. So I am now here. I'm gonna cross over to the gardens. So this is where the theater is. I think the Rose Gardens should be around here. So that's where we're gonna go. But yeah, check it out. It is here's a bee having a champagne moment. What I like about this park is that there's like different elements to it. So even like here, you have like this little winding part that feels like it's leading me to, I don't know, Narnia or something. the waterfall should be behind there, but it's only a bit quiet, so I'm not sure. I hope it's actually functioning. If not, that'll be a bit of a bore, but you know, it is what it is. I haven't been to the waterfall in a while, so that's also a thing. So I have no idea whether it's still going and stuff, but yeah, I like that. So I like this. Even on the side, like there's a whole kind of botanical garden feel, and then there's like a fountain and it's like manicured, you know, trees next to it and stuff, and it's those like little elements, so it's like a pleasure garden. Keep going back to that. It really is a pleasure garden. Feast for the eyes. Even though I'm wearing sunglasses, I know I'll take them off later. Okay, so it turns out my instincts were right. They did actually shut it off. So this is where you'd normally have the waterfall. Yeah, usually it's not as quiet. You could actually, usually can like hear it from a bit of a while away. But yeah, normally it would be here. And it'd be flowing. But there's nothing. So, sorry. So I'm gonna try and do this a bit presenter style. Yeah, so it's another part of the park, another bridge over troubled waters, who knows, maybe, maybe not. And then on the other side behind me is a rose garden, so we'll do that and see that. But for now I thought maybe let's try something different. Can you see me? As you can see behind me, that's the entrance to the Rose Garden. So it's quite circular inside. And yeah, there are lots of different rose varieties as they are even on the outside. So as you can see, rose, 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 you know, more rows, and the bridge where I was just now. So it's quite expensive. And yeah, we'll go into the rose garden, shall we? One of the things that I love about this garden is also the naming of like the roses. So as you can see here, there's one called Double Delight. And if you look at it, oh, where is it? Here. Yeah, it's really double color, double delight. Simple. Okay, so here we are. Rose garden, sitting on a bench. Yeah, enjoying the sights. It's the serenity. Also, I love that statue. You can see it, like this cherub. And yeah, so time for some much needed snacks, some ice cream, I think, and charge the phone because it needs charging, and yeah, take a bit of a break, and I'll catch you. Checking out little friend. Lovely lady. Like me, am I a lovely lady? I don't know. Let's see. But yeah. Oh, Ingrid Bergman. So shout out to some film people. She has a rose named after her, and she is actually numero uno, number one. It's kind of awesome. Anyway, let's go. So here we are, a different part of Regent's Park. This is probably like my favorite part. It's like this whole pathway, it's so picturesque, and they're always like, I think, switching up the flowers. So you come here at different time, it'll be different flowers. They just change it up all the time. It's the walkway, it's the fountain at the back, it's things like this, you know, these like parts here. I absolutely love it. And actually one reason why I wore black today is just so that like everything else hopefully will pop around me, so I'm not not gonna say it, but anyway, I love this place. Here we are, yet again, different side of the park. What I like about this side is that there's like sculptures, so it's that drive to have art in the middle of the beauty. I do love that combination of like art and nature, and especially because a lot of things that are like made from like metal, and they just look slightly out of place but also in place, you know, so it's quite beautiful in that way. Like I like the combination of that, and also because I think it makes it less boring but also brings it into the modern age, right? Because yeah, there's a level of modernity on this side, where you find on the other side it's a bit more, you kind of feel like the way that it is on the rose garden side is the way that it was when it all began, you know. Whereas with this side, it's like there's an attempt to bring it to now, and also try and link it to the future. So I like that aspect of this side of the park. And also being here at Regent's Park, actually, funny enough, it actually, I think of, you know, Centenary Park, Bulawayo, and I think there's so much that could be done, and it can look so stunning and amazing. And also some of it can even be like, you know, students, horticulture students, you know, being able to learn from experience at Centenary Park. Like, I don't see why that isn't, why that can't even be, you know, a thing. And looking at how many fountains here are working, and Centenary Park, there was like one big fountain which sometimes works, sometimes isn't, you know, water, blah blah blah, there's always something. And I think to myself, like, also wouldn't it be like amazing to have something like this Eluveve or Enketa or whatever, because you look at like how colonialism worked, right? A lot of it was about creating nice places closer to the suburbs, right? Whereas actually the place where, you know, a lot of people live should have these elements, right? The nice things, the park where people can go and have a picnic, whereas Yelanjo Pil, you know, even if it's just a sandwich. But it was a place where, like, I find here with the parks, right, people who work in the city, they come and they just chill in the park for, you know, your lunchtime. Take a breath, take a breather, go to the park, go have your lunch, or just take a walk somewhere nice, somewhere that kind of detaches you from the office, and then you come back and you're fresh. And I'm like, you know, that needs to be something that can be there in Juve, you know? In Juve, in Keta, Chavalala, there should be like a slice of green. That's nice, you know, Elama flowers. And just well kept and maintained, and yeah. But anyway. Thank you for sticking around, cutie.